but being here and then seeing how fast those dogs go, it's insane. They run up to 50 miles an hour, these dogs. Crazy. Yeah, you could definitely tell those dogs were excited to get out there and run. It was like a game to them. They get to go play. So they loaded them up in their trucks. And I'm following them over to the kennel or whatever where the dogs stay. That's big property back here, huh?
Yeah,
that's all this stuff.
The old lady that owns it, she does big maintenance on it. So it comes in and she's been along for a long time.
Oh, yeah?
On her house. She's one of them old women.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I got septic at my house. This is where they kind of hang out and run around. They got a lot of room to run around.
This is our
hey guys.
I have 75 in here.
75 dogs?
Yeah, I've got one empty. Plus these two here, these are our house pets, mine and AJ's house pets.
Oh, that's your
pet. And they want to come in the morning. Those are whippets.
Oh, okay.
But if we leave them home, they get pissed. They want really? To come in
here. Really? Aww.
Huggins.
That's the signal that we're going to go somewhere?
Yeah, because when they go to the race, they get the leads.
Ah.
So they associate the leads with going to the race.
Oh.
And that's what they do.
Oh, wow.
Hey.
Yeah.
Have to ball up this carpet.
Lay on it like that.
You just have to wear their muzzles until they eat. Mm-hmm. And they'll get them off later.
Now these guys go outside and run around too, huh?
Yeah. They go, this whole kennel goes out at once.
At one time?
Except for one dog. One dog doesn't like to go out with everybody. So she'll go out in a smaller
group. Mm. But they all go out at the same time?
Girls on one side, boys on the other.
Oh, okay.
She's really fast. They'll lose her. She'll end up going to sell.
Really?
Yeah. Right. We have a kennel. Candy. We have a kennel we break dogs in from Kansas. And they run at Southland. They've run out almost $2 million this year already. But they'll send us a bunch of puppies and then they'll pluck the really good ones. But that's okay because it gives us dogs to run.
Right.
And probably at least half these kennels there in the same place.
Now all these dogs in here run.
They all race.
They all race.
Some of them are waiting to go be a pet. She's waiting to go be a pet. Mm. Most of the pets they put over in the other.
You probably don't have any problem adopting these dogs out, do you?
We got groups we send them to.
Yeah.
What you doing, Ted?
Look at him. He's all kicked back. Hey! Ted is his name?
That's Ted.
What's up, Ted? Well, I'm just looking around. It's very clean in here. Doesn't smell at all.
You would never know there's 75 dogs in 75 here.
75 dogs in here, wow. And they all go out and play at the same time?
Yeah.
And they all eat together and stuff like that?
Well, I hand out feed pans.
Oh, okay.
And we'll be feeding in a little bit. I got a spread.
So everything that you guys do has to be documented?
Yep. Yeah. Like, when we get a dog in, when a dog leaves.
That's the name of the dog, the owner, white, red, female, tattoo numbers.
Wow.
If the state comes in,
you gotta have
they go, okay, who's that dog? You've got to have it in this. If you don't have it in this book, you get fined, and then you get warned, and then the next time you lose your license.
Wow.
And the ones here.
And when you lose your license, you're done.
You're done.
Wow, okay.
So we get inspected 3 times a week.
Wow.
They come in here 3 times a week.
So you gotta have your ducks in a row constantly at all times. So none of these dogs, they don't look mean or they're not growling at me or anything. Or, like, if let's just say if I picked a dog at random, like, say, I don't know, this one, they let you pet it, they let you, yeah, see? He's like, hey, look, hi. Look at him.
Aww. His name's Assassin.
Assassin?
He's really big. Fast.
Wow, look at the muscles on this dude. Wow.
He's a pretty small male. He's only 68.
Hey. Yeah, he's nice to play, right? Very cool.
Yeah. Now you have Jersey. You get up?
The cages are super clean. Look how big this guy is.
He's a monster.
Wow. He's big. He doesn't look ripped. He's ripped, but he doesn't look as ripped as some of these others.
A lot of what I hear is you know, they can't get up. They can't turn around. Their crates are so small.
No,
but you know if they don't see for their own eyes, they just keep looking.
This is Bailey. She's really friendly.
Yeah.
Amazing.
So you guys got to lift them up into this thing?
No, they jump.
They jump up there? Hi, baby.
Come on, baby. Come on. You support him down.
Oh, okay.
Bailey, up. Come on, up.
Wow. I guess so. They just leap up there like a cat.
They're wagging their tails. This is what they know. They spend the first 12 to 13 months of their life, and if you want to go out to my boss's and see his farm, they're in big runs. Mm. They spend their whole day out, and they're in groups of usually, as they get older, he splits them down to 2 and 3 animals.
Mm-hmm.
And they just spend, and they don't have muzzles on then.
Yeah.
And they just spend their days running up and down, playing. Whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Now his dogs have it good. He's got air conditioners in the dog houses.
Right.
But out in Kansas, they don't. They're just in big, long runs. Right. Run before the race. The state goes out there with a little cup on the end of a pole. And like you'll see, cocaine test. There is absolutely no tolerance. That's why that'll come up. Because it could have been, somebody could have patted them before they ran over at the track.
Mm.
You know, when we go to weigh in, we let people pat them.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody's got something on their hands. The amount that they come up with, somebody could still get hired as a police officer or whatever if they got.
It's so minuscule.
It's ridiculous.
When we hand over the dogs to the place, they're handled by so many people.
Mm.
And we can't see them.
Once they go into the jitney pit, we're not allowed to touch them.
Mm.
Like a racehorse, the trainer walks the horse out to the track.
Mm-hmm.
We bring the dogs over to the track at 12:30, and some of these dogs don't run till like 5:15.
Wow.
And we can't touch them.
Mm.
It's called the jitney pit, and they're locked out. But you got lead outs, you got track officials. You know, when I take some of my dogs to weigh in, I let people pat them.
Right.
You know, maybe I shouldn't, but I try and let people see how friendly they are.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
She thinks everyone's there for her.
Mm-hmm.
If I walk, she's usually in the last race, and I walk her down the tarmac, and she goes up to every person she sees to be
right.
Pat. It takes me 10
they'll
minutes
go out,
to get to the
we get here 5 down a lot of the track, and the vets and all that, it's just not true.
Right.
You know, the vet just lives 5 minutes away. We just got to get
this one's beautiful.
And then he evaluates.
He's a blue. You don't see him
wow.
Very often.
And then if he says, the dog needs to be seen by a clinic, then we go over to the emergency clinic.
Mm-hmm.
And then he makes the appointment for another vet. So,
Now, these dogs get drug tested every time they run, or is it just one?
They spot 2 and 3 dogs.
They just pick them at random and test them.
There's some tracks.
And it's a pee test, you said?
No, and then sometimes that'll stay in their
nothing system. To, like, enhance them.
No.
Steroids or anything.
All the bitches.
Each drug is listed, class 1, class 2, class 3. You get caught with a class 1 or class 2.
Your license is gone.
You'll be suspended for a while. And then what they'll do is they'll let you back after 3 months. And if you get anything, the minor thing, you're done.
And you're saying once they revoke your license, you ain't getting it back.
You're not getting it back.
And it's reciprocal. If you've lost your license in another state, you can't get it here.
So if you get thrown out here, you're done in the other
state. Yeah, you can't get in any place.
It's not worth the risk.
No.